Hey, so I'm glad you stopped by. I was hoping you would, because, tiger sharks, yeah? We know them, we love them, but we need to talk about them and ask some critical questions. Like, where the hell did they come from? So, let's back up for a sec. I was relaxing, reading the book, The Lives of Sharks, by Daniel Abbo and Dean Grubbs. And I get to the page dedicated to tiger sharks, and it mentioned something that set off a spark in my head. There's one tiger shark, as in, it's the only one in its family. Sure, it technically belongs to the ground sharks, but the tiger shark is in a category all its own. So obviously I started looking a little deeper, because I couldn't believe I never thought about this before. And boy, did this lead me down a rabbit hole. When we look at the tiger shark at face value, there are a number of things that distinguish them from other sharks. Some of the most notable being their size, as they're at the upper end of shark size tier list, their square-shaped head, and their teeth. While hammerheads win the award for the most unique head, the tiger shark wins the award for the most unique teeth. Look at this chart here. For the most part, shark teeth have the same basic plan as far as shape goes. Triangle, with each tooth having a different function depending on what the shark is doing. The two oddballs in the group are the teeth from the seven-gilled shark, which seven gills require their own video down the road, and the teeth of the tiger shark. Again, there's one species of tiger shark, and they're the only shark with this kind of tooth. So I asked the question from before, where the actual hell did they come from? Thanos didn't snap his fingers and tiger sharks were suddenly in the ocean. They had to have come from somewhere. Who were the tiger shark's ancestors? This led me to an article written by Julia Turcha and her colleagues, published in 2021, called Evolution, Diversity, and Disparity of the Tiger Shark Lineage, Galeocerida in Deep Time. And holy this article is a gem. So let's pause here for a sec. I have this article linked in the description below. Please save it to your bookmarks and give it a thorough read later. I am begging you. If you're a tiger shark enthusiast, you will reference this article multiple times. It shows that the secret of the tiger shark's story is indeed in the teeth. But it goes so much deeper than that. First and foremost, how many tiger shark ancestors were there? Originally, we thought there were 22 of them, which, wow, that's a lot. But this article goes into great detail to prove and confirm that there are actually only 5 species of Galeocerida throughout the evolutionary timeline, with the present-day tiger shark being number 6. Now, I know what you're thinking. That's quite a dip from 22. How did they come to that conclusion? Again, the teeth, or as the article puts it, the dental disparity, the morphological details in the teeth. See, here's the thing. To the average person, teeth just look like small knives or small triangles. They're big, they're sharp, they're scary to people. Got it. Things get interesting, however, when you take a closer look, which is just what these scientists did. They broke the tooth of a tiger shark into landmarks and sections. Looking at this picture from the article, number 1 is known as the distal cutting edge. Number 2 is the mesial cutting edge. And number 3 is the tip of the cusp. Those are the three landmarks. The semi-landmarks are those small circles you see around the tooth. After that, the scientists situated 28 semi-landmarks at the base of the tooth, between the distal and the mesial edge, or landmark 1 and landmark 2. And on both sides of the tip of the cusp, 18 landmarks, as in 18 from 1 to 3 and 18 from 2 to 3. It is these landmarks and semi-landmarks that allowed Julia and her colleagues to not only identify the different Galeoceridae species, but note the dental disparity throughout time. The six species are as follows in order from oldest to newest. Galeoceridae eaglesomi, Galeoceridae clarkensis, Galeoceridae aduncus, Galeoceridae mayumbensis, Galeoceridae capellini, and finally, our beloved tiger shark, Galeoceridae cuvier. Here is a picture I created so you can see all of the different tooth sizes relative to one another. Take a screenshot of this, as I'm going to be referring to it a lot. Take one of this as well, showing where they popped up on the timeline and for how long. Now, let's take note of something. Look at the tooth of G. eaglesomi. I'm just going to say G for Galeoceridae to make things a little simpler. Looking at this tooth, we can see a bit of the basic shark-shaped tooth. But we can also see, at the top, signs of dental morphology beginning to evolve into its own. In fact, the tiger shark tooth shape we know and love has been established by the time we get to the next species, G. clarkensis. They then evolved into G. aduncus during the Oligocene period. This is the species that, based on the evolutionary timeline, did a lot of legwork for the Galeoceridae family. Look at the size chart I made, and we can see that G. aduncus paved the way for Galeoceridae to start getting larger during the Miocene period. Who else was around during the Miocene era? Because whales were getting larger and meaner around this time, a trend started by Bacillosaurus back in the Eocene, sharks began to get larger as a response. Now, G. mayumbensis showed up during the Miocene and didn't get as large as Megalodon. In fact, this is when Galeoceridae, at least based on the teeth we have, began to grow to sizes approaching the modern day tiger shark. However, the fact that it didn't get as big as Megalodon may not have been a bad thing. When you have a body the size of Megalodon, you have to feed that body. Both prehistoric white sharks and tigers staying around the sizes we see today meant that they needed less of a caloric payday to survive when times got tough. We see that from the Miocene to the present day, the size of Galeoceridae remained consistent. But there's still a piece of the puzzle we're missing, and it's here that we must call upon the teachings and guidance of Aristotle. Specifically, the thing I always have running in my head whenever I look at something in nature, knowing that something exists and why something exists are two different questions, both of equal importance. We know that prehistoric tiger sharks existed, but we still have to answer the million-dollar question. Why did the tiger shark develop such unique teeth? I was going through the article and my notes as this question was sitting in my head. Taking a break from it, I decided to continue the book, The Lives of Sharks. Now, Normally when I read books like this, I ignore the small captions and facts at the corners of each page. But for a change, I decided to check out the one at the bottom left of the page for the tiger shark, and there it was. Turns out, tiger sharks have a little secret. Their jaws are less calcified than the jaws of other sharks. This makes them more flexible and can bend slightly to help the tiger shark adjust when biting something. Now, this is a strange adaptation that really doesn't work unless you have specialized teeth like a can opener. Oh wait. Once this piece of information came to me, everything fell into place. My fellow sharks, what is the tiger shark known for? Being the garbage cans of the ocean, with all manner of objects being found in their stomachs. Let me do you one better. What shark literally has the most variety in its diet? More than any other shark, it makes perfect sense. The shape of the teeth, the flexible jaws, the square head. The tiger shark is literally built different. Built to be the ultimate generalist predator, with enough size and intelligence to command respect from most creatures in the ocean. Why grow as big as Megalodon when you already eat literally whatever you want? Mass extinction going on? You can eat and survive on what little animals happen to survive alongside you. Why is the tiger shark the only member in its family? Because there only needs to be one species of tiger shark. At a certain point, they didn't have to diversify. They can eat anything and everything. And here's the cherry on top. Tiger sharks are the ultimate generalists. And still, the number of people killed by them in the past 400 years is less than 50. Let that sink in. What we have here is the product of Mother Nature taking a fish and daring it to survive any and everything it threw at it. And the fish won. See, I told you we need to rename the tiger shark to the eczema shark in my last video, because it's the literal definition of the Latin word eczemas. Extraordinary, excellent, and superb. This is just another example of why sharks are the absolute coolest animals in the world. Do not at me. For real though, I hope this makes you guys appreciate the tiger shark a lot more. And please, go give that article a read. You will not be disappointed. Thank you for once again giving me some of your time. Remember to go to the gym, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then.